Good day, everyone. I am super excited to be here today to be a part of the Energy Informatics Academy Conference 2022. My name is Simon Hedegård Jessen, and I'm a 4 plus 4 PhD student at the Center for Energy Informatics. I will today be presenting the paper named Identification of Natural Disaster Impacted Electricity Load Profiles with K-Means Clustering Algorithm. This paper has been conducted in close collaboration with my supervisors Cheng Mark Grace and Bo Nørregaard Jørgensen. So I hope you enjoy it, so please lean back, relax, and enjoy this presentation. Firstly, I will go through the agenda, so specifying the problem and challenges, what is the value proposition of this paper following the presentation on the methodology where the K-means clustering algorithm has been utilized as a key cornerstone. And then I will give a brief introduction to the case study where an Indonesian island has been utilized. Furthermore, showing the key results obtained from the paper and then the final conclusions. The problem at hand that electricity system operators are facing is a trifold challenge. Firstly, the electricity demand is growing exponentially in the great portion of the world's countries, and a lot of electricity system operators are promoting the deployment of renewable energy resources while outfacing fossil-based technologies. But this is not everything. The third leg is that the electricity system should be able to cope with these climate change and natural disaster induced power outages, which potentially can compromise the security of supply in the event of storms, extreme temperatures, or earthquakes. And this part with the climate changes and electricity system security of supply is the domain of this paper. For instance, the International Energy Agency has claimed that for every dollar invested in climate resilience infrastructure, $6 can be saved. So to look at what the current literature has focused on, the majority of the current literature has focused on the system adequacy, yielding capacity and grid adequacy, but this paper is focusing on the system security part, which is the ability to manage fallout systems elements during disruptions, and also the ability to manage sudden disturbances to the electricity system. If we plot this into an electricity supply chain illustration, the capacity adequacy challenges is put in the generation phase of the supply chain, whereas the grid adequacy is enhancements in existing grid infrastructure. But this paper will focus on the system security part where the electricity load profiles can be utilized. So if we dive into the dynamics of these daily electricity load profiles, then that can help unlock some insights into how well an electricity system's climate resilience capabilities are post disruptions, which could either be induced from technical hazards or natural disaster hazards, as you see on the left part of this illustration, whereas the right part of the illustration shows the climate resilience, where a lot of literature has focused on the robustness part, but not much literature has focused on the resourcefulness and recovery parts of the electricity system. So in order to contribute to this research gap, this paper aims to utilize the concept of climate resilience illustrated here, together with the unsupervised machine learning algorithm, K-means clustering algorithm, in order to identify and cluster normal electricity load profiles from abnormal electricity load profiles. Good. Moving on to the methodology, five overall steps were conducted in this paper. First of all, the power consumption profile was collected and prepared. Secondly, the clustering algorithm was selected, which was the k-means clustering algorithm, and deployed. And following the deployment of the k-means clustering algorithm, a seasonal distribution analysis was executed in order to reveal yearly, monthly, and daily characteristics of the daily electricity load profiles that lies within each cluster. And that put the fundament for performing cluster labeling, so tagging or naming each cluster with a name that was representative for the entire cluster. And then in the end, an electricity system climate resilience capability evaluation was performed, which could reveal how good the electricity system performs during natural disaster events and especially earthquakes. Diving into the exact application of the k-means clustering algorithm, the data input structure was daily electricity load profiles for each day from 2015 all the way to 2021. Thereafter, the elbow point method was utilized, where the k-means clustering algorithm was run with different numbers of clusters in order to illustrate the inertia value, and then the optimal amount of clusters could be selected or decided upon. And that amount of decided upon number of clusters was utilized for a final clustering in order to separate the data in a very good structure. The case study utilized was the island of Lombok, located east of Bali in Indonesia. And then you can see on the right part of the illustration the overall transmission system and where the major power plants were located. If we dive into the average daily electricity load profile for the island of Lombok from 2015 to 2021, then it is illustrated here on the right part of the figure, where the power consumption value is depicted on the Y value, and it's easily to see that there is a morning peak, and then we have a very significant evening peak. Going to the results were divided into four parts. Part one, there the intention was to cluster the entire data set from 2015 to 2021, and the optimal amount of clusters to utilize was 7, and the result of that was that each cluster ended up containing actually 1 year of data. So it didn't separate the daily electricity load profiles in normal and abnormal clusters. It just contained 1 year of data. So that didn't bring much value. But then the next intention was to cluster on a year-by-year data set. And that was done in the part two, where the intention was to illustrate all the years that had no significant disturbance impact. And the output of that was that we revealed that the 2019 and 2021 data set did not have any significant disturbance to their clusters. However, in part three, the below part, there we wanted to illustrate the years with significant disturbance impact, and it was shown that for the years 2015 to 2018 and the year of 2020, significant disturbance was revealed for more than one cluster in these data sets. And then part four consisted of a comparison of the electricity falls and natural disaster impacted load profiles. So diving into this part, where there were proven significant disturbance to the electricity load profiles in order to show some value proposition. If we look at the consecutive power load profile for the year of 2018, which is known as an earthquake year, spanning on this graph from January to December, then on the y-axis we have the power consumption values, then there are some clear power consumption drops. And actually for this year, there were identified three major natural disaster strikes materialized through earthquakes with a Richter scale value above 6.4. So if you look at the clustering results for this specific year, here we see on the x-axis daily time span, and then on the y-axis we have the power consumption value. And then each color represent one specific cluster, and then all the dashed lines represent the average for each cluster. So we can, for instance, see that the cluster with the forest green color that contained 87 samples or 87 daily electricity load profiles, and the name of that was appointed more than 90% weekdays in April plus October to December, because April and the amount from October to December are known as high consumption months in Lombok. Whereas, for instance, the lime colored cluster, which only contained 3 samples, that was named drastic load drops, 2 are non-natural disaster related, because this cluster contained 3 samples or 3 daily profiles, and 2 of them were not dependent on a natural disaster strike. And then a funny one, the gold one, contained 28 samples, and those were actually the Ramadan days for 2018. And then the red one, the most exciting and the most prominent one, it contains 16 daily electricity load profiles, and you can see it is on average the smallest of the clusters, and that was named as post-natural disaster days. And that's because it contained all the post-natural disaster days after earthquakes. That was, for instance, exemplified during a natural disaster strike on August 5, where you can see the power consumption values 10 days prior to this strike and 10 days post this strike. And then on the August 5, there was a natural disaster strike, an earthquake, a 7.0 Richter scale earthquake. And this, or the following days of this earthquake, those days were all put into the cluster with the post-natural disaster strike, and thereby indicating that the clustering algorithm was able to identify these post-natural disaster days because they had similar characteristics, so the same shape as the pre-earthquake days, but the magnitude of the power consumption values were lower. And if we then compare natural disasters and electrical faults, we could compare the natural disaster strike on August 5 with a power outage on October 15. The natural disaster strike on August 5, it took 50 days before full recovery was reached. But during a blackout on October 15, 2020, it took only 11 hours. So why this big difference in the climate resilience impact? Well, the reason for that is that the power outage on October 15 was a power outage on a power plant that led to zero production availability. So they very quickly managed to ramp up the electricity system, whereas the earthquake strike on August 5, that induced a earth sliding, which caused distribution poles to be to be destroyed, and thereby limiting access to electricity for a long time because they had to set up new distribution poles. So the overall evaluation of natural disaster and disturbance-induced consumption drops is that both earthquakes and power outages, they act the same way in the short-term perspective. There's no major difference. But in the long-term perspective, days to weeks after the natural disaster strike, there is a significant difference in how the electricity system copes with these disturbances. Finally, showing the conclusion and future work, the overall objective was to identify normal and abnormal electricity load profiles via the utilization of the k-means clustering algorithm, which was done. For instance, normal and natural disaster impacted and electrical fault impacted clusters was identified, and we could also manage to identify, for instance, the Ramadan period and some weekends in low consumption months. Furthermore, we performed the climate resilience investigation in order to evaluate on the electricity system's abilities to cope with disturbances. The future work consists of performing a similar analysis, but for an electricity system with a higher penetration. And then the references, which was the only reference that was referred to in the presentation. And then here, finally, I just want to say thank you for listening. And if you have any questions, then you are more than welcome to reach out and address them to me. Thank you.